Welcome to Mercedes-Benz of North Haven. We have fully remodeled our facility to give you and your vehicle an even better sales and service experience. Come see the full lineup of Mercedes-Benz and choose the car of your dreams. Sit and relax comfortably while you wait for your vehicle in our new service center. Let our knowledgeable and friendly staff take care of you and your Mercedes-Benz. Mercedes-Benz of North Haven, 620 Washington Avenue. See us online at mercedesbenzofnorthhaven.com.
Hi, I need a new debit card.
One moment, please, Stephen.
Great.
You should receive your new card within 10 to 12 business days.
10 to 12 business days?
Business days are considered Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
I know what business
Thursday,
days are.
Friday. Business days do not include.
It's time to bank human again.
Saturday.
That's why at TD Bank, all of our checking accounts come with a free debit card on the spot, any day of the week. TD Bank, America's most convenient bank.
Every season starts with a hope and a dream to play for the ultimate title, to become NCAA national champions. And you can experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Women's Frozen Four, March 21st and 23rd in Hammond, Connecticut, hosted by Quinnipiac University. Affordable tickets now available. Visit ncaa.com/tickets today and make a date with champions.
Sometimes it's like we're still in college. But with a mortgage, and the furniture's a lot nicer. And suddenly, the most important person in my life is someone I haven't even met yet.
Who matters most to you says the most about you. At MassMutual, we're owned by our policy owners, and they matter most to us. As you plan your next step, we'll help you get there.
Quinnipiac University is proud to announce the 4th Annual Quinnipiac Global Asset Management Education 4 Forum in New York City on March 20th to the 22nd, 2014. Industry leaders will discuss the global economy, alternative investments versus equities, Fed and Washington perspective, corporate governance, and global markets. Additional information is available on the web at game.quinnipiac.edu. Get in the game.
What if you could build a law school facility with the newest innovations and advanced technology? The kind of visionary design that brings together incredible learning and incredible community. The new Quinnipiac University School of Law Center, an impressive new facility for a bold new era. For more information, visit law.quinnipiac.edu.
This is the moment.
This is the moment.
Tonight is the night.
Tonight is the night.
This is the moment.
This is
the moment.
It's the return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac.
We'll fight till it's over. We'll fight till it's over.
This is the moment.
Return of the Mac.
Check out MacAchusetts.com for information on the Mac Basketball Championships in Springfield, Massachusetts from March 6th to the 10th, 2014.
Love my BMW of North Haven.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year at the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. The Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Welcome to Mercedes-Benz of North Haven. We have fully remodeled our facility to give you and your vehicle an even better.
Shot too hard off the backboard. Azatan controls a rebound. Turnaround jumper from eight is good. The Chandler at the foul line fakes, kicks it to his left for Ford. On the wing to the left corner, it's Conti with the jumper. It's good.
Well, nice pass.
Right wing gets picked from Drame, dribbles past the foul line, kicks to the right side for Hurst. Three-pointer from the right side is good.
Again, great drive that time.
The low post for Azatan. Spins to his left against a double team. Right-handed floater, no good. Gets his own rebound inside and banks it in.
I tell you what, he just doesn't give up on any.
Move the Bobcats into a Shirley. Left side bounce pass for Umar. Up court for Hurst in front of the Bobcat bench. Hurst to the foul line. Bounce pass inside. Azatan reverses. Good.
Hey, great job that time by Ike.
Pulls up, tries a shot put three-pointer. No good off the back iron. Rebounded to Shaq Shannon. Bobcats on the move. Shaq quickly up court for Drame ahead of the field. Pump fakes and banks it in.
Oh, great pass that time by Shaq.
Near sideline for Shaq Shannon. To the right corner, Sumbre. Baseline jumper for two is good.
I tell you what, he's short.
Alvarado with 11. On the other end, it's Hurst. Three-pointer from the right side. That's good, and he's fouled. He's got a shot for a four-point. Far sideline. Feet inside for Sumbre. Now down low for Azatan. Banks it in.
Again, nice high-low.
To his left, now to Ford, or rather Chandler, on the drive, underhand pass to Drame, hit the reverse.
Well, you know,
two-pointer straight away, instead finds Ford. Right wing, accelerates, right baseline, 10-footer in the air, good.
Well, nice pump fake, got the guy to stand up a little bit, takes the one
Cat
dribble.
Bench, brings it out to the half-court logo at the 10-minute mark of the second half. Three-pointer from straight away is good.
Williams kind of left him a little bit.
Gets the pass out to Chandler with three on the shot clock, his shot no good off the rim. Rebound, Azatan banks it in.
Wow, Brown passed that ball right.
67-66. Hurst, left corner jumper is good for three.
Yeah,
to the
great
shot clock. Umar to the foul line. Left side of the lane bumps with Pankey, but Azatan picks up a miss and knocks it down. ahead, and Shaq Shannon brings it into the front court, into the lane, bounces down low. Drame, reverse layup is good.
We had a first
nine on the shot clock. Hurst pulls up the jump. Good.
Yeah, it took a while for it to develop.
Hurst runs it out of the backcourt. Hurst down the right side. Driving shot, no good. Rebound, Conti. He fakes. He goes up with the left. Good.
Man, well, yeah, good productive move that time.
Court. Cooks on him tightly. Crossover dribble to the right side. Down low. Drame goes up. Misses the layup. Tip by Azatam. No good. Tip by Drame is good.
Now you disappoint.
Hurst throws ahead for Chandler. Chandler into the front court. And again throws it away, but knocked down. Chandler picks up the loose ball and lays it in.
Well, good heady play that time by Chandler. Makes a
side for Conti. Back top of the key for Umar Shannon. Returns to Conti, right side. Bounces down low for Drame. Gives to Hurst into the lane. Drives and lays. Umar Shannon returns to Conti, right side. Bounces down low for Drame. Gives to Hurst into the lane. Drives and lays it in with the left hand.
Well, good basket that cut that
top
time.
Of the key. Picks up the dribble. Now throws right side for Hurst. 9 on the shot clock. Hurst pulls up the jump. Good.
Yeah, it took a while.
The floor hands it off to Hurst. Foul line jump. Good.
Well, you know, Hurst
comes to the left side. Picked up by Drame and a switch. Goes to the basket. Blocked by Drame and out of bounds. Conti throws left side Chandler into the lane. Drops a pass out to Hurst for three. Good. Conti throws left side Chandler into the lane. Drops a pass out to Hurst for three. Good.
I let Hurst run with the ball a little bit, Billy. Good feed that time by Chandler and a little dish.
And defense by Hampton. Conti throws left side Chandler into the lane. Drops a pass out to Hurst for three. Good.
I let Hurst run with.
Conti throws right side for Hurst. Hurst along the right sideline. Looks to make a move. Pulls back the jump. Good. A three-point. Conti throws right side for Hurst. Hurst along the right sideline. Looks to make a move. Pulls back the jump. Good. A three-pointer by Hurst.
Well, he might be the guy, huh, to put the cape on. He might be
to
the
top of the key. Conti throws right side for Hurst. Hurst along the right sideline. Looks to make a move. Pulls back the jump. Good. A three-pointer by Hurst. Play gives it to a high post to Azatam. Drops it left corner. Hurst for three. Good.
And the crowd woke
up. Gives it to a high post to Azatam. Drops it left corner. Hurst for three. Good.
And the crowd woke up, right? They went zone, Billy. Real good feed that time.
Backs out. Now gives the ball to Chandler into the lane. Hands it off underneath. Drama, and he dunks with.
Three kids in particular, and two in particular, the Jones brothers had an incredible impact on that program, not only on the ice, but off the ice as well.
Goes left side to Hurst. Hurst into the lane. Pull up jump. Good. Goes left side to Hurst.
Hurst into the lane, pull-up jump, good. I think side to Hurst. Hurst into the lane, pull-up jump, good.
I think he wanted to
no good. Rebound, Zaid Hurst underneath Drame, up and in. The rim, no good. Rebound, Zaid Hurst underneath Drame, up and in. The rim, no good. Rebound, Zaid Hurst underneath Drame, up and in.
Well, what a feed that town.
Runs it into the front court, leaves it for Azatam, drives, lays it up, good, and a foul. Runs it into the front court, leaves it for Azatam, drives, lays it up, good, and a foul. Runs it in.
NEC was a program that had a lot of success through the course of the last 5 or 6 years. So when it came to Monmouth, they were the players that were all the players there. So he has to recycle
the roster at Monmouth, and over time now, this is his first year recruiting with a MAC team. He got a couple good freshmen starting tonight.
It'll be Usman Drame jumping it up against Zach Tillman. So we're ready for some MAC conference basketball. The tip controlled by the Bobcats. They put it in the hands of Shaq Shannon. He brings it into the front court. Picked up by Justin Robinson. Gives it along the right sideline for Umar Shannon. Now throws top of the key for Hurst. Back to Shannon, right side of the key. Along the right sideline, picks up his dribble, gives to Drame way up high. Now hands to Shannon, under 20 on the shot clock. Shannon backs up at the circle at midcourt. Shaq Shannon comes forward. Crossover dribble, top of the key. Gets it right side for Umar Shannon. 8 on the shot clock. Shaq Shannon puts up a 3. Good.
Now good possession that time. You talk about Tommy Moore wants to slow the game down a little bit and was able to get a ball reverse and a good release by Shannon.
So the Bobcats jump out on the three-point field goal by Shaq Shannon. Robinson into the front court. Hands it off to Tillman up high. Hands to Nicholas coming behind him. Nicholas down the lane to the basket. Goes up. It's a charge.
A good play that time by John May Billy. He met the dribbler, stepped out. His body was in place. I like the whistle.
So Andrew Nicholas picks up the foul, and the Bobcats pick up the basketball, and Shannon brings it up court for Quinnipiac. Opening minute here, 3-0, Bobcats in front. They give it to Hurst along the left sideline, bounces top of the key to Drame, throws along the right sideline for Shaq Shannon. Shannon dribbles, gives to Umar Shannon top of the key. Shannon picks up the dribble, gives to Hurst into the lane, drops it off. Shaq Shannon fakes a 3 into the lane, pass tipped and taken by Monmouth. On the run, Deion Jones quickly out of the backcourt to the basket, lays it up and hits.
Well, college basketball now, Billy, in transition is becoming a rebounder to a dribbler to a guy who scores 94 feet by Jones.
3-2, Bobcats lead it here. We played a minute and a half. Lob pass down low to Drame, dribbles to the lane, pass tipped but recovered by Hurst on the left side. Gets it out to Umar Shannon, standing in the circle at midcourt. Shannon comes forward, comes to the left side with the dribble, gives it off Drame at the foul line. The jump, good.
A real good pass that time by Umar Shannon as he comes off the dribble screen, Billy. Double team on a roll for Azatam, wide open Drame.
Quickly down court, Deion Jones loses the handle, but it's recovered in the lane. Blocked and knocked away by the Bobcats and recovered by Nicholas out along the right sideline. Puts it in the hands of Robinson. Monmouth, a team that likes to go, that likes to score in transition. Bobcats stop him that time. Down low, pass knocked away, recovered by Tillman underneath, and he lays it in.
A little unlucky that time by Quinnipiac. Good weak side help, and ball goes through the big man's hands to the other big fella.
5-4, Bobcats lead it here in the early goings. Zaid Hurst along the right sideline, bounces once, gets it down low to Drame, cross court, Umar Shannon for 3. Off the rim, no good. Rebound comes to the floor, and it's picked up by Robinson. Justin Robinson throws ahead for Jones. Deion Jones into the front court. Back to Robinson, the diminutive point guard. Back out along the sideline for Jones. Cross court, it goes to Nicholas. Pulls up. Here's the jump. Off the rim, no good. Rebound knocked to the floor. And saved by the Bobcats, but picked up by Tillman. His shot, no good. Rebound knocked to the floor. Picked up by Nicholas, and he lays it in. And Monmouth takes the lead.
Yeah, a couple games now, Billy, especially down at St. Peter's. Quinnipiac didn't recover fumbles, and Monmouth just got 3.
6-5, Monmouth in front here. Zone defense by the Hawks. Shannon gives along the right sideline. Hurst for 3. Off the back rim, no good. Rebounded by Monmouth. They kick it out. Robinson quickly into the front court. Dishes right side. Nicholas for 3. Good.
Good feed that time. And like you talked about, Willie, in transition and not afraid to go. Good cross-court pass, and the left-hander looked good.
9-5. Monmouth has scored 7 points in a row. We played 3.5 minutes. Top of the key, Umar Shannon gets it in the lane. Azatam, his first touch of the night. Down the lane, driving shot. Good as he banks it in.
Well, great job by Azatam. Billy got hit, bounced off there like a pinball, and knocked it in off the glass.
9-7, Monmouth in front. We've played 4 minutes as Robinson brings it into the front court for the Hawks. Comes along the right sideline, guarded by Umar Shannon. Gets it top of the key for Nicholas. Nicholas picks up the dribble, gives back to Robinson, down the left side to the basket, up and under. Rolls off the rim, no good, and rebounded by Drame. Throws it out to Umar Shannon. Shannon brings it into the front court for the Bobcats. Comes left side, kicks it out for Hurst. Does not take the wide open three. Gives to Shaq Shannon, top of the key. Shaq Shannon directs traffic. Bobcats down by two here in the early going. Gives to Hurst, left side, goes to the top of the key, now to the foul line. They throws right side off the hands of Shaq Shannon and recovered by Deion Jones. Jones out of the backcourt for Monmouth. Comes into the left corner, kicks it out. Nicholas has room for three. Off the back rim, no good. Long rebound, Jones. Jones dribbles through the lane, now kicks it out to Robinson. Robinson looks back at the coach, King Rice. Now calls out a play. We've played almost 5 minutes, Monmouth by two. Robinson to the left side, gives to Jones, right side of the key, back to Robinson. Bounces down low to a cutting Nicholas into the corner. Picks up the dribble, now gives it along the sideline, Robinson. 10 on the shot clock for Monmouth. Robinson off a pick, top of the key, down the lane, spins, gets it out, Jones. 5 on the shot clock, pull up, jump, way off the mark. Jones gets his rebound, blocked by Drame and recovered by Shaq Shannon. Shannon brings it into the front court. Shannon to the top of the key, gives left side, Umar Shannon, gets it down low to Azatam. Azatam faces the basket, looks to make a move, now puts up the jump, good.
Yeah, better patience with the ball down there by Azatam. One concern early, Billy, both teams really tired. 6 minutes in the game, no media timeout. Quinnipiac's not team rebounding.
Game tied at 9 as we approach the 14-minute mark. We're almost 6 minutes in. Brady right side, the big 6'10 guy, gives it to the other 6'10 guy, Tillman, top of the key. Now throws on the left side for Robinson to Nicholas. Down the left side, shot blocked from behind. Recovered under the basket by Monmouth and knocked loose. Nicholas picks it up. Left corner jump is in and out. Rebound comes to the floor and a whistle and a foul. Tell you what, Monmouth, King Rice talked about this, and we're going to go to break, but he talked about it in the pregame show that boxing out is like the main theme tonight because they got out-rebounded so terribly down at Monmouth. They're boxing out.
Yes, they really are, Willie.
All right, timeout on the floor, 13:55 remaining first half. Quinnipiac 9, Monmouth 9. We'll be right back.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year. At the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut, the Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best with an exquisite cuisine of natural.
Welcome to Mercedes-Benz of North Haven. We have fully remodeled our facility to give you and your vehicle an even better sales and service experience. Come see the full lineup of Mercedes-Benz and choose the car of your dreams. Sit and relax comfortably while you wait for your vehicle in our new service center. Let our knowledgeable and friendly staff take care of you and your Mercedes-Benz. Mercedes-Benz of North Haven, 620 Washington Avenue. See us online at MercedesBenzOfNorthHaven.com. Welcome to Mercedes. Love my BMW of North Haven.
Was up against Niagara in a preliminary game, the women's game, and we thought Quinnipiac could beat that team. Billy, you talked about boxing out, and the challenge for Quinnipiac is not to accept the box out. Mm-hmm. So someone's going to put the body on you. You got to work around that, work through it. If you accept box outs, Mama's going to have a good opportunity here. Right now, Billy, 8 rebounds to 2, 6 offensive rebounds for Mama.
Kasim Chandler, along with James Ford and Marquise Barnett into the lineup as Chris Brady at the line hits on the first free throw.
Marquise getting an opportunity, and I think Tommy Moore is telling Azatam, we need someone that's going to bang a little bit. So Barnett's in there for one reason, and rebound.
He is, misses the second, rebounded by Drame, pitches it out to Umar Shannon, who brings it into the front court. Shannon, top of the key, comes to the left side against a zone defense, lobs it down low. Drame fakes, goes up. They're calling it a blocked shot, and it goes out of bounds. Looks like he got mugged under there.
Man, one mistake he made now, and a real good step through by Umar Shannon. When you're 6'11", play 6'11". Keep the ball up in the air and finish that play up high.
Bobcats will inbound from the baseline. Chandler looks, now lobs it into Umar Shannon along the right sideline. Shannon waits, hands to Kasim Chandler coming behind him. 15 on the shot clock, left side for James Ford. Ford bounces the ball, waits, 10 on the shot clock, gives to Umar Shannon, calls out a play, now 7 on the shot clock. Has a pick, comes to the right side, gets double teamed away from it, 2 on the shot clock, forces the shot, off the rim, no good, rebounded by Rudiker. Rudiker hands it off, and running it out of the backcourt is Josh Jones into the left corner. DeLeo, his shot, no good, rebounded by James Ford. Kicks it out for Shannon. Shannon into the front court, pulls up, three-pointer, good.
Yeah, he got in rhythm that time. You know, he took that one as the clock was winding down. That time, real good bet, real good bounce, steps into the three.
Bobcats by 2, 12-10, under 13 minutes to play in the first half. Josh James gives it on the left side for O'Gara. Tyrone O'Gara gives it top of the key to James. James throws on the right side now for Nicholas. Nicholas to DeLeo, top of the key to O'Gara on the left side. Looks to make a move, goes, bangs with Drame and an offensive foul. So Usman Drame picks up the second charge as O'Gara is charged with the foul.
You can tell when you're invested in a game. You can tell with Drame now, Billy, he's ready to play defense. Second time, like you said, he took a charge. He met the dribbler. Good start for defensively for Drame.
Azatam back in. Barnett goes to the bench for the Bobcats. Quinnipiac with the ball. Zone defense by Monmouth. Right side for James Ford. Picks up his dribble. Now gives top of the key to Chandler. Chandler back to Ford. Right side. Looks to make a move. Cut off at the baseline. Down low it goes to Azatam. Double teamed. Gets a long pass out. Top of the key. Chandler. Left side. Umar Shannon. Shannon. Pull up. Jump. Good.
I like to see it to him a little bit quicker on a ball reverse by Chandler because Shannon makes the three. Little late on the delivery. Only 2.
Bobcats by 4. 14-10. 12 minutes remaining in the first half. Left side it goes for O'Gara. Out top of the key, Nicholas. His jump off the back rim, no good. Battle for the rebound. Tipped and taken by Umar Shannon. Shannon runs it into the front court for the Bobcats. Comes to the left side, down the left side. Picks up the dribble, gets double teamed, needs help. Jumps it cross court for James Ford. An aggressive zone defense by Monmouth. Bobcats with the ball, they lob it down, loaded Drame, double team, cross court pass to Chandler into the lane, running one-hander, no good, whistle, and a charge. Chandler goes banging into Josh James, and Monmouth will take over, but first we're going to go to a timeout. 11:27 remaining in the first half, Quinnipiac 14, Monmouth 10 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Have you had your coffee today? Oh, you're on your third cup already? This is Dan Darling of CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com. And along with that third cup, how about a coffee break for the soul? Go to CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com and create your username and password, and I'll provide...
Hi, I need a new debit card.
One moment, please, Stephen.
Great.
You should receive your new card within 10 to 12 business days.
10 to 12 business days?
Business days are considered Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
I know what business
Thursday,
days are.
Friday. Business days do not include.
It's time to bank human again.
Saturday.
That's why at TD Bank, all of our checking accounts come with a free debit card on the spot, any day of the week. TD Bank, America's most convenient bank.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year. At the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut, the Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Get on a roll here. Mama's doing a good job defensively, scrambling a little bit. You're catching a low post, they're doubling, and they're leaving quick. You've got to make the quick release. You can't stand. You got to move and help your teammate.
Josh James quickly up court for Monmouth. Gives it top of the key for O'Gara. Now to DeLeo at the foul line. Throws it to O'Gara along the right side. Hands off Jones. Off a pick. Here's the jump. Oh, it's short. Rebound battled for and taken by Drame. Hands to Shaq Shannon, who's back in. Shannon brings it into the front court. Crossover dribble to the left side. Down low it goes to Azatam, goes to the basket, up and under, shot no good, tip Drame, no good, and then rebounded by Monmouth. And then stolen by Drame, ball loose on the floor, but it's picked up by Jones. Jones drives to the basket, now gets it out to Leo, thought about a three, gets it to James, throws left side, O'Gara, down low in the lane, Rudiker shot blocked by Drama and gets it ahead for Chandler. Chandler out of the backcourt, drops it into the lane for Azatam, and he's fouled as he takes the pass.
Well, that's a Usman Drama, I think, that you dream about as a coach, as one who's really active, goes for balls, dives on the floor for loose balls, and if you could bottle that up in Usman Drama, you'd have a first-team All-MAC player and maybe an All-Region player.
He is certainly dominating the game tonight. Bobcats to inbound from the baseline on the non-shooting foul. Inbounded Ford for three. Off the back rim, no good. They tip the rebound, taken by Sumbrey, and he goes up and is fouled. A.J. Sumbrey into the ball game, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
The amazing thing about 18- and 19-year-old kids, and that's the front court for Monmouth, Billy. As they go through the scout, they realize they need to put the body on Quinnipiac players. The game starts to do an incredible job. You talked about it 6 minutes in. As you get into the basketball game, you forget about what you're supposed to do. Quinnipiac now starting to doing a real good job on the offense.
Three hits on the first. One more coming. The big freshman out of East Windsor, New Jersey.
You see, that's why dogs have them collars, dude, and they have the invisible fence. Because when they forget, you can buzz them.
Sumbrey makes both foul shots. And the Bobcat lead is 6, 16-10. Bobcats put on pressure in the backcourt. Justin Robinson is back in the game. Gives it away. Now Robinson has the ball tipped, knocked out of bounds, and last touch by the Bobcats. So again, Bobcats put on full court pressure.
2 seconds now, Billy, otherwise it's a half court violation.
Looking to inbound, they get it in. Now they get another 10 after it's knocked out of bounds. But the shot clock keeps going down. It's down to 20. They get it along the baseline. Jones goes to the basket, goes up for the shot. And a whistle and a foul. Ford blocked it from behind, but Sumbrey got him out in front. Sumbrey picks up the foul, and it'll be Deion Jones to the line to shoot two for Monmouth.
I'm going to have to check on that rule. It doesn't seem right to me. It wasn't a change in possession. Why you would get 10 more seconds?
You know what? I like the way you think, but unfortunately, that's what the rule is.
Yeah.
The rule, it gets knocked out of bounds, and you retain possession to get another 10 seconds.
Now Jones make the free throw here, and you're seeing all too familiar now in the world of college basketball, especially at this level. The best players on your team are guys that transfer from another team. Right? You got Jones that played at Towson. He comes to Monmouth and is now their best player.
Second free throw by Jones is good. So he makes two foul shots. The Bobcat lead is 4, 16-12. Almost midway through the first half. Chandler out of the backcourt to face the zone defense. Comes to the top of the key. Left side it goes to Umar Shannon. Shannon back to Chandler. Chandler holds the ball. Fires right side. Ford for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Robinson. Fires up ahead for James. James down the right side to the basket, swatted away. I believe it was Ford that got that one and knocked it out of bounds.
Yeah, good effort by James Ford. And you talk about James Ford now. He's missed shots he's supposed to make, but he's become a basketball player. Real good job in transition blocking that shot.
Andrew Nicholas back in for Monmouth. And they will inbound the ball from the baseline. Inbounded to Tillman in the corner. Gets it out to Jones behind the arc. Throws left side Robinson. Now back to Jones. Jones to the foul line. Kicks it back to Robinson behind the arc. 20 on the shot clock. Right side Jones. Looks to go baseline against Drame. Goes to the basket. Up and under. Nice reverse is good.
Yeah, used the rim that time. Looked like he was going to pop to the right. Left-handed. Drame couldn't block it because of the rim.
Bobcats by 2, 16-14. 9:20 remaining in the first half. Umar Shannon right side for the Bobcats against the zone defense. Left side it goes to Chandler. Now back right side for Shannon. Fakes a three. Dribbles. Hands it off to Hurst. Gets it down low for Drame. Underneath to Drame, rather. His shot no good. Tipped by Drame. No good. He misses two bunnies underneath. Rebound Nicholas brings it up court as Monmouth looks to get even here. Down by two. Left side for James. Now hands it off to Jones. Top of the key. Here's to Robinson, out to Nicholas, who spins into the lane, back out to James. They now put it in the hands of Robinson, looks back at the bench. King Rice tells him, spread out the floor, 10 on the shot clock. Robinson puts the ball on the floor. Comes off a pick, right side, backdoor pass, knocked away, recovered in the lane. Tillman up with the shot, no good. Did not hit the rim. It's a shot clock violation.
A good defensive effort. And, you know, I'm seeing it with Monmouth team. It's a contradiction in terms. They played 94 feet as fast as you possibly can be. Then they slow it down and pound the ball. So really different in terms of what they're doing offensively.
Bobcats with the ball and a two-point lead. Kasim Chandler, top of the key, gets into the lane, kicks it out right side. Hurst fakes a three, goes baseline, kicks it into the lane looking for Sumbury, and it's knocked out of bounds but off the hands of Sumbury.
That's two times now you've seen Hurst wide open from 21 feet. He doesn't take the shot. And against Monmouth, you need to knock down the three. You can't take it into traffic.
Well, they got the middle clogged with a zone defense. 8 minutes remaining in the half. Bobcats lead by two. Justin Robinson out of the backcourt, gives to Nicholas on the right side, back to Robinson, top of the key. Comes to the left side, goes to Jones, puts up a three, and hits.
Tough matchup again because Drame's on Jones. They pull him out a little bit. Real difficult for Drame to close out on a 6'5" wingman.
Jones has 9 points, and Monmouth goes out in front, 17-16. Hurst, top of the key, gives left side for Shannon into the left baseline. Sumbury, his jump off the rim, no good. Rebound knocked to the floor, picked up by Robinson, quickly out of the backcourt, gives to James down the left side, goes up for the shot, good, and he's fouled. Again, Monmouth real tough in transition. Josh James hits the bucket before he goes to the line to try to make it a three-point play. We'll go to a timeout. 7:30 remaining in the first half. Monmouth 19, Quinnipiac 16, and we'll be right back.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids.
This is the moment.
Tonight is the night.
Tonight is the night.
This is the moment.
This is
the moment.
It's the return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac.
We'll fight till it's over. We'll fight till it's over.
This is the moment.
Return of the Mac.
Check out MacMassachusetts.com for information on the Mac Basketball Championships in Springfield, Massachusetts from March 6th to the 10th, 2014.
Flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Mass Mutual Center in Springfield, Massachusetts, March 6th through the 10th. All session tickets start at $99 for 20 action-packed games of Mac Madness. That's just $5 per game. To purchase tickets, visit MacSports.com, Ticketmaster.com, any Ticketmaster outlet, the Mass Mutual Center box office, or charge by phone at 800-745-3000.
8-7.
Hey, in this basketball game here, Billy, you know, you talk about how well Drame's played on the defensive end. He's been active, but he's missed a lot of layups. He's 1-for-5 from the field, and Quinnipiac as a team misses a lot of layups. And I can't tell if it's because they take that eye off the target, they assume it's going in, but they just don't finish the easy plays. And those things come back. You know, you're up 6 points against Monmouth, you don't make plays. They push it up, knock down a three, and, you know, you're right back in to a competitive basketball game.
Josh James trying to complete a three-point play and does. So Monmouth out to a four-point lead now on a three-point field goal and a three-point play the old-fashioned way. Pressure in the backcourt. Shannon's pass tipped and stolen by Robinson into the right corner. Nicholas for three. Good.
We got to throw the ball ahead against pressure. You can't go backwards against pressure. You got to attack, throw over the top, throw to the middle, and play.
Pass again is tipped. Looked and picked up by James, hands off. Nicholas drives, plays it in, and he's fouled. Nicholas now with 10 points. Deion Jones has 9, and Monmouth has shot out to a 9-point lead.
Well, just not a real good job. I mean, a poor job by Quinnipiac in their press offense. Two turnovers that turned into 3-point plays, one an old-fashioned three and one a knockdown three. And against pressure, it doesn't appear as if A.J. Sumbury has any idea where he's supposed to be. You see Shannon has the ball. If you double team, you've got to have somebody on the strong side, Billy. You've got to have somebody in the middle of the court, and you have to have somebody behind the ball. If you have people in those positions, there's not a press in the country that can beat you. Yet Quinnipiac didn't have any players there, and that's why Monmouth has turned it over.
They didn't have anybody behind the dribbler, and the dribbler picked it up and gets double teamed and had nothing to do with it.
You can't go into a double team and pick the dribble up. You got to back away from the double team make them chase you, and then you need help from your teammate to come meet the basketball. So a good timeout over there by King Rice on a timeout, made a change defensively and shook Quinnipiac up a little bit.
This timeout was taken by Tom Moore to try and shake his guys up. Andrew Nicholas will go to the line to try to make this a three-point play. He's got 10 points, 2 3-point field goals, and now with a chance to make a three-point play the old-fashioned way and give Monmouth a double-digit lead.
Well, they came out you quick here, Billy. I mean, they were down six, so they've turned this thing on a 16-0 run against the Bobcats.
Misses the foul shot, Drame the rebound. 9-point lead for Monmouth with 7 minutes remaining in the first half. Shaq Shannon calls out a play, flips left side for Umar Shannon, top of the key to Ford, throws on the right side now for Hurst. Gives to Umar Shannon, top of the key, man-to-man defense now by Monmouth. They give it along the right sideline for Hurst. 14 on the shot clock to Shaq Shannon, top of the key. Shaq Shannon calls out a play. Drame comes up, sets a high pick. Shannon off the pick, puts up a three, off the back rim, no good. Rebound taken by Monmouth. Tillman kicks it out, James into the front court. James dribbles right side, gives it off. Nicholas bounces down low to Tillman. Tillman takes a step, travels, and hands it over to the Bobcats.
Offensively, Quinnipiac is not in any rhythm, Billy. I mean, they're holding it till the shot clock. There's no one coming off the screen. No one's dribbling the gap. So offensively, a lot of standing, Quinnipiac offensively.
And Monmouth back in the zone defense as they bring it into the front court to the left side for Hurst. Gives it top of the key to Shannon, throws on the right side for Shaq Shannon. Shannon back to Umar Shannon, top of the key. Flips left side for James Ford. Ford dribbles out top of the key. Now to Hurst in the lane. The jump off the back rim. No good. And rebounded by Monmouth. Boy, they're attacking the boards this time. Robinson down court. Down to the basket. Up. Lays it in. The 5'8". Robinson goes in and lays it up.
Well, did a good job. I didn't think he was going to be able to pull that off. But a small lineup now for Quinnipiac. He was able to get underneath and make a good acrobatic move.
An 11-point lead for Monmouth with 5:40 remaining in the half. Left side, Shaq Shannon. Shannon dribbles the ball, goes to the baseline, to the basket, goes up, shot blocked and knocked out of bounds. Ike Azatam back in for Quinnipiac. And he will replace Shaq Shannon. DeLeo checks back in for Monmouth, and he replaces Robinson. Also, Brady back in. He replaces Tillman for Monmouth. 5.5 minutes remaining. Again, not a highlight reel first half for the Bobcats. They're down by 11. Into the left corner for Ford. Gets it to Azatam. Drives the lane up with the shot off the rim. No good, but he's fouled.
Now, you missed an opportunity that time. As soon as Ford got the ball inbounds to Azatam, if he slips it underneath, Umar Shannon has a layup. So, Quinnipiac is just not sharp offensively. Doing a lot of holding the basketball, and they're not attacking gaps. They're playing along the perimeter, and you really have no production from one of the perimeter guys, whether it's Shannon.
Azatam misses the first free throw. Bobcats down by 11, 5:28 remaining in the first half. Rebounded by Drame and lays it in as Azatam missed the free throw, but Drame cleans it up. Bobcats, though, down by 9 here with just over 5 minutes to play in the first half. Josh James into the front court, looks back at King Rice, gets a play, calls it along the left sideline. Picks up the dribble, gets to Nicholas, top of the key, guarded by Hurst. Nicholas, crossover dribble to the lane, spins up with the shot, rolls off the rim, no good, rebound Azatam. Gets it ahead for Shannon. Umar Shannon into the front court to Hurst on the left side. Gives it at the foul line. Azatam down the lane, tipped away, stolen, ball loose on the floor. And a foul as Ford going for the loose ball. Fouls DeLeo and turns the ball over to Monmouth.
Unlucky that time. Azatam made a real good move. And you got to hold that ball into your chest, Billy. And then you got to make the pass. Leaving it out, Monmouth's got quick hands. And as long as Quinnipiac is going to stand offensively, Monmouth is going to have an opportunity to guard a handful of Quinnipiac players with one guy.
Monmouth with the ball. They lead it 27-18, 4:40 remaining in the half. Off the pick, Nicholas dribbles to the top of the key, hands it off to Jones. Deion Jones gets to DeLeo, top of the key, right side to Nicholas, goes to the baseline, spins, reverse layup is good. Nicholas now with a dozen points for Monmouth, and they're up by 11. Bobcats up court. Shannon into the front court, faces a zone defense by Monmouth. It's given the Bobcats fits here in the first half. Shannon, top of the key, off a pick, puts up a three. In and out, no good. It's rebounded by Jones. Kicks it up ahead to James. James out of the backcourt, down the lane, pass, and he gets it right in the hands of Hurst. Hurst brings it up court for the Bobcats, gives to Shannon. 4 minutes left in the half. Shannon moves toward the basket, and he's held as he goes. Max DeLeo picks up the foul, and we pick up a timeout. 3:59 remaining in the first half. Monmouth 29, Quinnipiac 18 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hamden.
Step inside the most unique arena in all of college sports for Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball. Take your seat, then leap out of your seat and cheer on the men's and women's teams as they drive to the big dance. It's Major Division I MAC Conference basketball, and you're sitting so close you can see your reflection in the gleaming hardwood. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball, the only thing as exciting as the home team is the home court.
Hi, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. I'm here to announce to you that K&J is currently running half off any tree work as a winter special. This offer won't last long, so please give us a call and remove those unsafe and unwanted trees. With some of the most experienced personnel in the industry, you could breathe easy knowing you're in good hands with K&J Tree Removal. Call us today for half-price winter tree removal, 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733, or visit us on the web at KJTreeRemoval.com.
Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca from the TD Bank Sports Center. Men's basketball, a tick under 4 minutes remaining in the first half. Monmouth leading Quinnipiac 29-18. Women's basketball, well, things have slowed down considerably at St. Peter's. They played 4 minutes and it's still the same score. Quinnipiac leading 20-7 with under 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Well, similar to Quinnipiac offensively here, Billy, over the course of the last 8 minutes, Bobcats are 1-for-12 from the field. And that's the first time you made an athletic move by a guard to dribble into a gap. If you do that, you're going to put pressure on Monmouth, and sloppy again with Umar Shannon with the basketball. Got to make an athletic move when you double team.
They're not playing with the intensity that you need against this kind of a defense. Yeah, I mean, they're coming at you.
Yeah, and Quinnipiac, unfortunately, is playing a little bit lackadaisical. They got to get a lot tougher.
Inbound to the Ford in the backcourt, brings it across the line, hands to Shaq Shannon, gets double team, gets it away to Umar Shannon, left corner for Hurst. Hurst into the lane, pull up, jump, good.
You've got to attack on a real good move that time by Zaid Hurst. He needs to step up and make plays for Quinnipiac.
29-20, Monmouth in front with 3.5 remaining in the first half. Right side to Leo. Holds the ball over his head, gets it down low to Tillman. Zach Tillman back to the basket, backs in on Drame, up with the shot, way off the mark and rebounded by Ford. Ford fires into the front court for Hurst. Hurst on the move, down the right side, pull up, jump at the baseline, no good. Tip by Drame is good.
A good job by Hurst, forcing the action a little bit. Drame active inside, and yeah, you can bail out here in the first half. Get yourself back in a position so your big two are playing, Azatam and Drame.
3 minutes remaining, first half. Bobcats trail 29-22. James into the lane, pull up, jump, short, rebounded by Drame. Kicks it ahead for Ford. Ford quickly into the front court, comes to the right side, slows down. Gets it to Drame, who puts it in the hands of Shaq Shannon. Shannon calls out a play. Gives it to Umar Shannon, left side, now to Ford, top of the key. Ford throws to Shaq Shannon on the right side. Tom Moore screaming from the bench, calling out a play. Now Shaq Shannon to the top of the key, 12 on the shot clock. Stutter steps, kicks it out. Umar Shannon down the lane. Scoop shot is good.
I think he yelled Omaha.
That was Omaha, all right. Beautiful scoop shot by Umar Shannon. And the Bobcats have cut the Monmouth lead down to 5 with 6 straight points.
In a game of basketball, you either can play banana basketball where everything's in the shape of a banana and you just roll the ball out on the perimeter, or you can go ahead and knife and cut. And in basketball, if you knife and cut, like you saw Shannon do twice, you saw Zaid Hurst twice, it puts pressure on the defense because in the zone, Billy, they don't know how to guard. If you just roll the ball out in the shape of a banana, they can play you. Good adjustment by Quinnipiac players, but it seems as if they got a little more interested and certainly playing better offense than they did early in the first half.
I mean, you know, this is the kind of conference, Billy, where you've got to come with intensity every conference game. Otherwise, you're going to be in trouble.
Your best players have to make plays. So you go through a period of time where your five starters are averaging in double figures. Someone's getting 17, someone's getting 16, Hurst is getting 14. Well, guess what? You're halfway through the season. That's what you need to do every game. You can't take any nights off from your production.
I'm Monmouth with the basketball. 2:20 left in the half, and the Bobcats trailing by five, but they've cut an 11-point lead down to five. Robinson to the top of the key, hands it off to Jones. Jones into the lane, driving shot, plunked by Drame. And then Drame up with the loose ball, hands to Umar Shannon. Shannon into the front court, gives to Hurst, into the right corner, Shaq Shannon for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, Hurst goes up, no good. Rebound, Ford, and he lays it in.
Wow, man, it's a different team there. Like, who was that other group? Costume. They dressed up for Halloween
in January.
Were.
Yep. Under 2 minutes to play in the half, and the Bobcats have cut an 11-point lead, 11-point deficit down to three. Nicholas along the right sideline gets it out top of the key, almost threw it into the backcourt. DeLeo recovers it and gets it on the right side for Deion Jones. Jones now accelerates down the lane, spins, gets it out top of the key for Robinson to the foul line, to the basket, shot blocked from behind. By, I think it was Hurst that blocked it, knocked out of bounds as he blocked it on the 6'10 Tillman. Six on the shot clock for Monmouth.
Now, Quinnipiac's done a good job getting back in his basketball game, exerting a little more energy, but collectively as a group, you have some sense of what they're attempting to do.
Lobbed into Jones, top of the key, hands it off to Nicholas. Nicholas tries to move, two on the shot clock, just throws the ball up in the air, and it's a shot clock violation. Monmouth couldn't get the shot off. Good defense by the Bobcats.
I thought that was really good. We got great officials here again, Billy, led by Brian O'Connell. He tried to bait you into making that call with a three-pointer as the clock was winding down. Referee didn't fall into it. Good job by Hurst. He's woken up a little bit.
Minute 17 left in the half. Bobcats down by three, but they've scored eight straight points to get it to within three. Umar Shannon into the front court. Gives to Chandler, who's in the ball game. Back to Shannon. Shannon to the the ball. Now comes back out, gives to Chandler left side, back to Umar Shannon, top of the key, off a pick to the right side. Fakes, puts up a jump, short, rebound, Shannon in the lane, back out, Ford for three, good, and we're tied at 29.
James Ford's given the team a little bit of life, hasn't he, Willie?
He has indeed. 11 straight points for the Bobcats have evened the score. 40 seconds left in the half, and Monmouth wondering what just hit them in the last minute and a half.
You got a dose of Hurst, Ford, and Drame.
Robinson just dribbling in the circle at midcourt. 15 on the shot clock, 24 on the game clock, so they have to take a shot, and the Bobcats will get the basketball. Robinson crossover dribble to the left side, to the basket, dumps it underneath to Tillman, and he dunks.
Yeah, that's one I think they baited Drame, right? And he knew he was going to try to block it, and the big fellow was able to knock one down.
5 seconds left in the half. Shannon fakes, forces a three off the back rim, and that's the way the half will end. So Monmouth regains the lead, but the Bobcats with a great comeback after 1-29 Monmouth at halftime.
Well, real good job by Quinnipiac, Billy, over the course of the last 3 minutes and 57 seconds. They started collectively playing as a group, and some kids made plays. So get in the locker room at halftime, make some adjustments offensively, remind the guys what you need to do, dribble, drive, gap, make a play. Good job by Quinnipiac to get back in it.
All right, we are at intermission, and the Bobcats down by two, 31-29. Stay where you are. We will be back with more right after this. All right, two teams still huddled up, ready to make their way back out onto the court. Monmouth will have the basketball to start the second half, leading it by two. Only one guy in double figures for either team, and that is Andrew Nicholas. He's got a dozen points, including a couple of three-point field goals for the Bobcats. As Billy said, 7-6-5.
4-3-2. So, I mean, in a game of, you got to hang in there and hope someone doesn't have a straight to tie in yours, but that's not going to win a lot of hands at Mohegan Sun. You need to get some kings and some aces, and let's look for Asatam to have a big second half here.
All right, Monmouth with the basketball, and we start the second half as Justin Robinson moves into the front court, picked up by Umar Shannon. Throws right side for Nicholas, back to Robinson. Now flips on the left side for Deion Jones. Jones bounces once, gives to Nicholas top of the key. Now they put it back in the hands of Robinson. Robinson comes to the left side, spins, now throws right side Nicholas into the corner for Jones. Jones to the basket. Underneath, the shot is good by Brady.
They kind of figured out if you take the ball to Drame inside like Jones did, he's going to come and try to help to block the shot. You got to get weak side help.
Shaq Shannon kicks it back out. Hurst for three. In and out, no good. Rebounded by Tillman. Four-point Monmouth lead here in the first minute of the second half. Lob pass down low for Brady under the basket. Blocked from behind by Drame. Recovered at the foul line by James into the corner. Nicholas for three. No, but it's rebounded by Tillman to Nicholas, cutting down the lane, and the floater is good.
That dude never stops moving. He's really hard to play. He shoots the three. He moves quick. Real active without the ball.
And Monmouth has opened it up to a six-point lead here in the opening minutes of the second half. Asatam at the foul line. Bounces once out to Hurst for three. Good.
Care whether he makes them or not, Billy. That's not the point. He's got to take them. And that time he was able to go ahead and right the ship and knock one down.
And it cuts the Monmouth lead in half. Hawks lead it 35-32. A minute and a half into the second half. Robinson left side, holds the ball over his head, waits for somebody to cut into the lane. It's picked up there by Tillman. Back out Robinson for three. In and out, no good, but a whistle and a foul. Chris Brady pushing off to get the rebound, commits the foul.
The same thing we saw in the beginning of the game with the two bigs for Monmouth and Brady and Tillman. When they're rested, and they just got 15 minutes of rest at halftime, they move you around pretty good with their lower body. As time goes on, they get tired, and they get awkward with the ball, and Quinnipiac can make a push.
Shaq Shannon moves it up court. Bobcats down by three. Gives it along the left sideline for Hurst. Back to Shaq Shannon. Top of the key throws to Umar Shannon on the right side. Umar to the top of the key, gives to Shaq Shannon. Down underneath, Drame, turnaround jump is good.
Real good job by Umar Shannon, who went and dribbled the gap, kicked it, and then you had an open player inside. Good feed.
Bobcats down by one, 35-34. We're early in the second half. Deion Jones, left side, holds the ball. Now gives it top of the key for Robinson. Robinson bounces once, gives back to Jones. Jones gives it off. Nicholas. Nicholas into the lane. Pulls up. Left-hand shot. No good. Rebound by Asatam. Kicks it out to Shannon. Umar Shannon into the front court. Shannon avoids a pick. Pulls up the jump. Good.
Real good job by Umar Shannon. Looks really good with the ball, doesn't he? I mean, you can tell the difference between a freshman and a fifth-year senior. You can tell Shannon's a fifth-year senior.
He is, and the Bobcats are up by one, 36-35. Seven straight points for the Bobcats to put them out in front. Early second half, Justin Robinson comes to the top. He throws right side for Tillman. Zach Tillman back to Robinson. Looks over at the coach, King Rice. Gets a play, calls out the play, gives it right side for Nicholas. Now to Robinson. Robinson holds it along the sideline, a whistle and a foul. Zaid Hurst getting worn out by Nicholas, who, as you said, does not stop. And Hurst called for holding.
Well, he's like a green fly at the beach.
Yeah.
Always coming at you, and just when you think you're going to hit him, he gets out of the way, and you got to face him again.
Inbounded on the non-shooting foul. Robinson comes to the top of the key, picked up by Shannon, hands it off to Jones, coming behind him, throws right side for Nicholas into the right corner for Robinson. Bounces it down low for Tillman. Tillman spins, cut off at the baseline, double-teamed, trying to get it away, hands it off. Jones up with the shot. No good, but he's fouled. Good defense, but Tillman managing to get the ball to Jones for an open look, and Jones gets fouled.
There's two reasons why you double team a low post player. The first reason is they're real good. The second reason is they got real bad hands. Now, Quinnipiac's going at Tillman because he has bad hands. So when that happens and you have him double teamed, your defenders can't stare at the ball because you lose sight of your man. You got to guard your man and see man and ball, and that's how that ball got through to Jones.
So Jones to the line to shoot two. First one is up and good. And he is now in double figures with 10 points. Tyrone Aguero into the ball game, and he'll replace Chris Brady for Monmouth. Jones, one more free throw coming. Game tied at 36. Free throw up with the right hand and good. 11 points for Deion Jones, and Monmouth back in front by a point, 37 to 36. They press in the backcourt. Shaq Shannon picks up the dribble, gets it ahead, knocked away, and stolen by Monmouth. Very careless with the basketball against the full court pressure. Monmouth with the ball. Jones hands it off to Robinson. And Bill Mecca has disappeared. Where'd you go?
I was so disappointed. I threw my pen at the stat monitor, and it fell into the stands.
I got you. Left side it goes. Nicholas. Nicholas to the lane, to the basket, spins, knocked out of his hands and out of bounds. Good defense by Hurst. Zaid Hurst is going to know he played a game tonight. He's getting a workout.
Well, he's going to be tired. That's true. He needs an energy drink or some Pedialyte. You know, you got who's got a baby in here? We need some Pedialyte.
Inbound to Nicholas again on the run to the basket. Lays it up. No good. Rebounded by Hurst. Gets it ahead. Shaq Shannon. Shannon into the front court. Stutter steps. Kicks it back for Hurst. Hurst drives to the lane. Pulls up. Gets it out. Umar Shannon. Baseline jump. Good.
You got to get him the ball, right? That's what they do in the pros. Like when you're hot, you just go to run some plays for Shannon, and Shannon's on a roll.
Bobcats by one, 38-37. Umar Shannon now with 11 points for Quinnipiac. We've played just over 4 minutes of the second half. Monmouth slowly into the front court. Justin Robinson, top of the key, guarded by Shannon. Comes to the left side, picks up the dribble, hands off to Aguero. Aguero to the basket, double team shot blocked, but a whistle and a foul. Usman Drame commits the foul, and that brings us to a timeout. 15:25 remaining. It's Quinnipiac 38, Monmouth 37, and we will be right back.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year at the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. The Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Hi, this is Bill Schweitzer. You know, when you can't get to a game, listen on AM 1220 WQUN or on any mobile device by downloading the Quinnipiac Bobcats app and then clicking on radio. Or the TuneIn Radio app and search for WQUN. They're both free. And after the game, listen to the Morrow Motors post-game show when you're driving back down the hill. Hear comments from a coach, highlights from the game, and pearls of wisdom from Bill Mecca.
Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca with you. 15:25 left in the game. Quinnipiac leads Monmouth 38-37, and they got a fight on their hands, Billy.
Yes, they do. I think... You know, through the first 5 minutes, Monmouth does what they did in the beginning of the game. They put a body on you, and Quinnipiac hasn't been able to go ahead and get offensive rebounds. So we go back to what we said. You either accept the box out and Monmouth gets the ball, or you spin off, get active, or get your perimeter guys like Hurst to become a rebounder.
Women's basketball tonight down at Jersey City. Second half just underway, about a minute and a half into the second half. Quinnipiac leads St. Peter's 32-17.
Well, that's more like it for... This Quinnipiac women's basketball team struggled against Manhattan on a home game the other day, and 46 three-pointers the Lady Cats took that afternoon, Willie.
Ooh, they hoist them up, don't
they? That's a lot, man, 46. Wow.
Tyrone Aguero at the line, a sophomore out of Newark, New Jersey. His first free throw is good. Game is tied.
Monmouth goes a lot more athletic now. They take Brady and Tillman out, and now they're playing with a regular-sized team. Front court probably goes 6'7", 6'5". Pace of play will pick up. Look for Monmouth to press with this lineup.
Second free throw in and out, rebounded by Drame. Kicks it ahead for Shannon. Shannon quickly into the front court. Shannon dribbles it along the sideline. Now gets it to the top of the key for Shaq Shannon. Shannon throws along the left sideline for Hurst. Hurst dribbles, gets it down low to Drame, spins to the baseline, and he's fouled as he goes. Well, height mismatch there. Ogero, who goes at 6'5", trying to guard Drame, and held him as he went along the baseline.
Yeah, he had his forearm on his back that time, and Drame did a real good job spinning out of that and getting inside.
Non-shooting foul. Shaq Shannon inbounds to Umar Shannon in the left corner, gets double-teamed, and tries to get away from it, and a whistle, and let's see.
Timeout here, Coach.
Timeout called by Quinnipiac.
Now, let me ask you a question, partner. So, if every time I throw the ball into a corner on an out-of-bounds underneath, and when you catch it in the corner, you're double-teamed, and you take the ball out of bounds, I know you're a good player. You're not going to throw the ball to the guy in the corner.
No, that would not work.
And that's where basketball IQ really comes into play. And so many kids on so many teams at different levels, the highest and the lowest, continue to make the same mental mistakes. They're not thinking about what their opponent's going to do when their opponent has done it over and over and over again. And that's the difference between what we used to do and how they do it now.
Yeah, you got to make adjustments. I mean, you got to make adjustments on the fly in this game. That's the way it's been played for ever since it was invented by that guy up in Springfield.
Yeah, basketball's not
a... Who was it, Tipson?
Tipson. Was it Tipson? Basketball's not a complicated game. It was, like you two said it right on the head. It was invented by PE directors like Bob Tipson, who aren't the most brilliant people in the world, dude.
Oh, come on
it's
now.
It's basketball.
Tipson's a Rhodes Scholar among physical education guys.
I'll give you this. Tipson's a lot smarter than me, but I'm no messer, dude. So he might have graduated magnum cum laude. I graduated glad I got out of
Bobcats with the ball following the timeout.
Omaha.
Omaha. Game tied at 38. 15 minutes remaining. Inbounded. Drame, double team, gets it away to Shaq Shannon out at the top of the key. Shannon picks up the dribble right side. Hurst wide open. The three off the back rim, no good. Rebound comes down, taken by Azatam, and he's pushed to the ground and fouled. Ogero will commit the foul. And that'll be team foul number 3 on Monmouth. So it's a non-shooting foul. Ogero will come out. And Zach Tillman back in for Monmouth. No, Ogero is going to stay in, and it's going to be Marcelo Rudiger. Inbounded, Drame lays it up and hits.
Real good pass that time by Shaq Shannon to Drame.
Two-point Bobcat lead as James brings it out of the backcourt. They get it to the right side for Jones. Deion Jones on the move, dribbles to the top of the key. Shaq Shannon on him, right side. It goes for Nicholas. Now back out top of the key for James. James comes left with the dribble. Now goes top of the key to Jones. Throws on the right side. Nicholas puts up a three off the rim. No good. Rebound Drame. Hands it off. Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt. Shannon comes along the right sideline with it. Now to Drame, who's up at the top of the key. Puts it in the hands of Umar Shannon. Just over 14 minutes to play. Bobcats by 2, 40-38. Hurst left side gives to Shannon, top of the key. Umar Shannon holds the ball back to Hurst. Hurst on the left side, bounces to the foul line for Azatam. Azatam on the move, and a reach-in foul is committed. Zach Tillman commits the foul. Team foul number 4 on Monmouth, so it's a non-shooting foul. Kasim Chandler will check in for the Bobcats. He's going to replace Shaq Shannon.
Shannon, segment of 4 minutes there, Willie.
He did. Kasim Chandler to inbound. Looking, gets it in, and throws it right to Tillman. Hands it off. James out of the backcourt, 3-on-1, hands to Jones, and Jones lays it in.
Well, you turn the ball over underneath, man. It's a fast break waiting to happen for your opponent.
He tried to get it to Azatam. Azatam was double-teamed, and Azatam never moved toward the ball.
He just stood. It was just a bad out-of-bounds play. He didn't want to throw it to the corner, and made a mistake.
Game tied at 40. Drame gets it out to Hurst, goes to the right baseline. Fadeaway jump. Good.
Good job by Drame, Billy, playing the point forward up there at the top of the key, being able to put it between his legs and dish it for a jumper.
Drame having an outstanding night tonight. He's got a dozen rebounds, and he's got 10 points, a double-double for him already.
Yeah, he's been special.
James along the right sideline gets it down low to the baseline. Nicholas has the shot blocked, but it's recovered underneath by Tillman, who lays it in.
Another mistake down there, though, by John Maybilly. Asatam had him. He didn't need to go over there. He needed to stay with his guy to clear the ball off the boards.
Game tied at 42, under 13 minutes to play. Umar Shannon on the right side. Along the right sideline, dribbles once, puts up a three. Off the back rim, no good. Long rebound taken by Jones. Deion Jones races out of the back court and is a reach-in foul committed by Kasim Chandler.
First questionable shot, I think, Umar Shannon took. I mean, he's been playing pretty hard now for the first 7 minutes. Contested three-pointer. I think one you probably want to get the ball inside to your money guys and Azatam and let him make some plays.
12:45 left. Game tied at 42. Ball inbounded to Tillman along the right sideline. Gets to Ogero, top of the key. Ogero hands it off to DeLeo, who just checked in. Waits and gives to James. Josh James gives it left side for Ogero to Jones. Pull-up jump is good.
Yeah, Jones and Nichols do a real good job off the ball, moving, cutting without it. Really difficult to guard.
15 for Deion Jones and a two-point lead for Monmouth, 44-42. Just over 12 minutes to play. Kasim Chandler gives to Hurst, top of the key, back to Chandler along the left sideline. Dribbles, comes to the top of the key with it against the zone defense by Monmouth. Throws right side for Shannon, 15 on the shot clock to Chandler, into the left corner for Hurst. Goes to the baseline, cut off, 10 on the shot clock. Chandler, top of the key, comes off a pick, into the lane, has it stripped and stolen by DeLeo. Kicks it up ahead for Jones. Jones gets it down low, James. Reverse layup, no good. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Monmouth.
It's a game that Kasim Chandler right now doesn't have a feel for. Wouldn't be surprised, Billy, if he comes out.
11:48 remaining. There's a timeout on the floor. It's Monmouth 44, Quinnipiac 42 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hamden.
Step inside the most unique arena in all of college sports for Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball. Take your seat, then leap out of your seat and cheer on the men's and women's teams as they drive to the big dance. It's Major Division I MAC Conference basketball, and you're sitting so close you can see your reflection in the gleaming hardwood. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball, the only...
Quinnipiac University is proud to announce the 4th Annual Quinnipiac Global Asset Management Education 4 Forum in New York City on March 20th to the 22nd, 2014. Industry leaders will discuss the global economy, alternative investments versus equities, Fed and Washington perspective, corporate governance, and global markets. Additional information is available on the web at game.quinnipiac.edu. Get in the game.
What if you could build a law school facility with the newest innovations and advanced technology? The kind of visionary design that brings together incredible learning and incredible community. The new Quinnipiac University School of Law Center, an impressive new facility for a bold new era. For more information, visit law.quinnipiac.edu.
By the young kid, Kasim Chandler, who's, you know, as a young guy, you got to know you got to come pre-prepared. He made a move, and Chandler's going to watch the majority of this, I think, on the bench.
They get it into Hurst, puts it in the hands of Umar Shannon, and Shannon brings it up court. Comes across the line, man-to-man defense now by Monmouth. Gives it along the right sideline for James Fort. Gets it down low for Azatam. Azatam wants a clear out. Doesn't get it, still double-teamed. Comes to the baseline, to the basket, goes up, shot blocked, foul called. Now, Drame that time went in and clogged up the same side. He needed to bring his man out to the other side.
I think he felt that Azatam was a wing player, and he thought he was forward because he wanted to post up, and Azatam was waiting to go one-on-one off the bounce. Everybody cleared out, and like you said, Drame went, oh, low post ball side? That's my position. Let me go there.
Azatam's free throw rolls off. So Shaq Shannon, Zaid Hurst, James Ford, along with Drame and Azatam on the floor for the Bobcats. Ike Azatam with one more free throw coming.
Azatam early on this season now, 75% from the line, Billy, 0-for-4 tonight.
Misses two, but rebound Drame as it poked away, recovered by Hurst along the baseline. Gets it out, Shaq Shannon. Shannon to Hurst for three. Good.
Always throw the ball back to the guy who threw it to you against the zone. He will be wide open Good job by Shannon, who's done a good job at the point.
10 points now for Hurst, and the Bobcats back out in front by one, 45-44 with 11 minutes remaining. Josh James to the left side for Monmouth. Holds the ball over his head. Waits. Now dribbles to the top of the key. Throws right side for DeLeo. Max DeLeo holds the ball. Watched by Shaq Shannon. 10 on the shot clock. Gets away with a travel. Hands it off to James. Has it blocked and taken away by Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt to Azatam, who dunks.
Real good feed that time. Shannon's becoming that floor general you thought about, Billy, in the beginning of this season. Real good dish and a dunk. Right.
Quick timeout by the Bobcats. 10:35 remaining in Quinnipiac by 3, 47-44.
Nichols now, the left-hander who plays like Lynn Shackelford back in the day for the Lakers, mm-hmm. that dude could play. Mm-hmm. He moved a lot. He's got to come back in the basketball game, because when Nichols is in the game and Jones is in the game, they have two wing players that are going to run, which now opens up the dribble drive. This time on the dribble drive, it was congested. You turn out and Quinnipiac blows it out. And maybe Quinnipiac can move ahead here, Billy. It's been nip and tuck the whole time.
Well, quite frankly, Billy, Andrew Nicholas, the guy that you say plays like Shackelford, and I don't disagree with that, and Deion Jones, between the two of them, they've scored 29 of Monmouth's 44 points.
And they've done it on the go. And the challenge you have is it's difficult to move as much as they're moving and still be able to catch the ball and make a play. So you got to get them rest. And that's what King Rice has done. He's got them a couple blows here. And we'll see now. Look for Nichols to get this ball here.
Monmouth with the basketball as Josh James brings it up court for the Hawks. Bobcats by three with just over 10 minutes remaining in the game. Comes to the top of the key, picked up by Ford. Comes to the left side, now throws right side for DeLeo. Into the right corner it goes for Nicholas. Gets it down low. Now a hook pass cross court for DeLeo. Gets it down low for Tillman. Tillman backs in on Barnett. Goes up with the shot, hits the basket, and he's fouled.
First time we saw any type of move by an offensive player who got rewarded with a little bit of contact. Barnett kind of backed away. If you're going to foul him, Marquise will foul. He didn't foul him, and he gets the benefit of the whistle, and he goes to the line.
Well, Barnett comes out, and Drame very quickly back in the lineup. Drame having a terrific night tonight. He's got 14 rebounds to go along with 10 points, 4 blocked shots. He's been terrific.
He really has, and he's been able to play point forward for Quinnipiac against man-to-man and against the matchup zone to catch it and then become the guy who's able to ball reverse. He has been really good, Willie.
Zach Tillman at the line. Monmouth down by one, trying to complete a three-point play. Flips up with the right hand and hits. Game even at 47. Pressure in the backcourt. Shaq Shannon faces a double team, still has the ball on the floor, hooks it into the front court to Azatam, drives to the basket, up with the shot, no, but he's fouled.
Well, I like what Quinnipiac did here. Two on one against press offense. You get it to Azatam, and he looks and he makes and he attacks the play. My concern, Billy, again, is against this pressure by Monmouth, you still don't have anybody behind the basketball, and he has no relief to throw it to. Mm-hmm. Quinnipiac almost turned that ball over.
They did. All right, Azatam at the line, where he has been 0-for-4 tonight. First.
You know, in years past, I think that 0-for-4 would have carried over. Mm-hmm. You know, I think it would have continued and he would have had a real enough rough night from the line. Can you watch his maturity? He's grown up. He's made an adjustment there. Look for Azatam to start making a couple.
9:56 left in the game. Quinnipiac leads by one, and Azatam has another free throw. Up with the right hand, and it's good. 49-47, the Bobcats. Under 10 minutes to play. Justin Robinson back in the lineup for Monmouth, brings the ball up court, met by Shaq Shannon as he comes across the midcourt line. Robinson comes to the right side, bounces into the right corner for Jones. Back to Robinson. Robinson on the move, comes left, gives it to Jones in the left corner, to the basket, goes up, lays it up, no good. Rebound comes down, stripped, knocked out of bounds by the Bobcats. Well, he got away with a travel on that one.
And he got away with a push off and, you know, active inside, and he got fortunate they got the ball back. So, you know, Quinnipiac, you got to get two stops and two scores. to get some separation.
Inbounded, they get it to Jones. Now James, top of the key, flips on the left side for Robinson. Back to Jones for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Azatam. Hands to Shaq Shannon. Shannon brings it up court for the Bobcats. Shannon gets it down low for Drame. Drame hooks a pass way out for Hurst. Catches it, comes to the top of the key, gives left side for Ford. He gets it down low to Azatam. Faces the basket at the left side. Azatam puts it on the floor. Backs in on Tillman, back out to Ford on the left, back to Azatam into the lane, goes back up, and a jump ball is called. They got tied up by Nicholas, but it is possession arrow Bobcats.
And maybe the first one I questioned from the refs tonight. His back was to the play, and clearly if you were looking like we were looking, his hands were all over Azatam. So first bad whistle I think I would quantify.
Quantify, man.
How about that?
Inbounded, Azatam drives to the basket, goes up, and he's fouled. Deion Jones commits the foul. For Jones, that will be number one. And Azatam will go back to the line to shoot two.
Azatam did a real good job. We get a chance on the replay, gathering himself. And you
Billy,
see
we're not on TV. The folks that are listening to us can't see the replay.
Oh, I thought we were doing TV.
No, TV today.
I'm sorry. Let me get back it up. That time Azatam did a great job drawing contact.
Free throw by Azatam is good. He now has 9 points after a very, very quiet first half. One more free throw coming. Boy, they're playing a chess game of who's lining up with who on the foul lanes. That's because Drame has gotten 2 offensive rebounds on missed free throws.
And if I was, honestly, if I was Monmouth, I would put Jones on the same side as Drame, not Tillman, because he's just so much quicker. And that's how he's getting a rebound, because his first step, he beats him to the ball.
Second free throw by Azatam is good. So Ike Azatam now in double figures with 10. 4 Bobcats in double figures. Azatam comes out of the game at the timeout. And Umar Shannon is back in. Bobcats by 4, 51-47 with under 9 minutes to play. Justin Robinson out of the backcourt, comes left side, gives top of the key to Jones, throws to Josh James along the left sideline. Now top of the key, Nicholas forces a three. It's no good. It's rebounded by Shaq Shannon. Shannon runs the ball up court, comes to the top of the key, pulls up for three off the back rim. Long rebound on a bad shot, and it's taken by Robinson. Robinson quickly up court, dishes left side. Nice play by Hurst. Knocks the ball away and out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a mistake. I mean, Shannon's done a great job. He's 1 for 5 from the field, but he's got to pass that shot up, get the ball inside. You've been making a living on the foul line, Billy. One of his few poor choices tonight.
Now he's going to come out of the game as Evan Conti will make his. Oh, no, he doesn't come out of the game. It's Zaid Hurst. I guess I should quit coaching here. But Hurst comes out. Now Conti is on Deion Jones. That is not a good matchup for the Bobcats for the inbound, stolen by Shaq Shannon. Shannon drives to the basket, and he's hammered by Jones. Bounces back up. He'll go to the line to shoot two. He had Conti. It was a 2-on-1 coming in, but Shaq Shannon decided he was going to take the shot, and Jones clobbered him.
He clobbered him, and that was an old-fashioned hard foul. Mm-hmm. The good news is Jones picks up his third personal foul. So should you have dished it off? I'm not sure. I like to play. 2 shots there, Willie?
No, 2 fouls on Jones.
Oh, darn it. Then he should have passed the ball.
You're on the beam here tonight, Mecca.
Balancing, baby.
Brian O'Connell, the head referee, overlooking at the replay.
And they're going to try and take a peek here if they thought it was a flagrant hard foul. It looked like a good old-fashioned.
Well, it was good old-fashioned, but these days those are called flagrants.
You thought that was a bit much?
He laid into him pretty good. You know, I think it's kind of a borderline. You can call that one either way.
The surprise I got from our team, and I say our team, well, yeah, obviously people know I'm a Quinnipiac fan, is you saw no Bobcat go to Jones. Usually when the players know it's over the top foul, you get your team to go to the guy and just say, hey, that's enough. We didn't see that happen there, mm-hmm. which lends me to believe it's just a good hard-nosed foul. Trust me, though, as this game moves on,
they'll get harder and harder.
And they're going to remember Jones, because uh-huh. Jones did make sure that Shannon knew he was coming.
Well, they still continue to check out the video of the foul to see whether it's going to be flagrant or not.
Big part of the game here for Quinnipiac.
And now all 3 officials are over discussing it. Now, we mentioned Brian O'Connell's name all night long, but the other two officials, Will Bush and Michael Pilla, have done an outstanding job tonight, I think.
I think, you know, again, this group is good. Mac's a big-time league. You know, real players, real officials, and they've done a job, and they're spending time, and you begin to wonder, are they going to make any calls here because they spend an inordinate amount of time looking at that replay.
Brian O'Connell goes over and gives King Rice the news as they give it the news to Tom Moore.
And they called a check, I think, Coach.
Well, they called it a flagrant, so he'll shoot the fouls and keep the ball. Is that not the way that works?
That's the way that works. And King Rice is going to talk to Jones and just probably ask him, why did you hit him so hard, but didn't really get into the ref a little bit. So they spent some time looking at it.
Shannon's first free throw is short.
Well, I remember Morgan Wooten would always tell Adrian Dantley and Kenny Carr that if someone's going to bang you around and beat you up that hard, the only way you can pay them back,
make the free throws.
Make the free throws. You got to make these free throws.
Bobcats will retain the basketball, and they still have a four-point lead, but looking for a little separation here with 8:27 remaining. Tyrone Ogero will check in, and the Jackrabbit, Andrew Nicholas, will go to the bench.
Boy, I tell you what, you got to make those plays. I mean, you're a guard. You got to step to the foul line. You got to make that foul shot.
Shannon lobs it in out deep to Umar Shannon along the left sideline. Umar Shannon holds the ball. 8:20 remaining. Bobcats with a four-point lead. Comes to the circle at midcourt, guarded by Josh James. Comes to the left side, hands it off to Shaq Shannon coming behind him. Shannon, top of the key, hands it off to Conti. Conti dribbles, hands it off to Umar Shannon. Under 20 on the shot clock. Looking for somebody to make a move. Ford tangled up, couldn't get loose. Umar Shannon down low for Conti. Reverse layup is good.
Real good feed by Umar Shannon. And you saw Evan Conti come to the ball out on the double team. Real good play up and under. Good job, Conti.
Bobcats by 6, 53-47 with 7:45 remaining. Ogero, top of the key, guarded by Conti. Gives it left side for Jones. Throws top of the key for Robinson. Robinson dribbles the ball, now throws along the right sideline for James. Josh James puts up the jump off the back rim, no good. Long rebound comes to Umar Shannon. Shannon quickly out of the backcourt, down the lane, driving shot off the rim, but that wouldn't have counted anyway. He was fouled before the shot. Josh James commits the foul, but Monmouth is over the limit, so Umar Shannon will shoot, but first we're going to go to a commercial. 7:28 remaining. It's Quinnipiac 53, Monmouth 47. We'll be right back.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Dang. Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch. Whoops. Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa. Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Yeah, welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer, Bill Mecca, the Bobcats with a 53-47 lead over Monmouth here. 7:28 remaining. Women's basketball down in Jersey City tonight. 7.5 remaining in that one. And Quinnipiac blowing the doors off St. Peter's, 57-33.
Well, you know what? And it's a Quinnipiac women's basketball team that really needs to get in a rhythm and get in a flow. You know, they had coming off such a great year, great early start, struggle losing some games they shouldn't. Maybe this will get them back and get their confidence back.
And, you know, earlier I chastised you for going to the instant replay, and our producer, the Jet, Paul Pacelli, reminding me during that timeout that the game is also being broadcast on YouTube with our audio. So there was a replay up, and I am duly chastised, Mr. Mecca. They were showing the replay for, and there's more than 150 people watching on YouTube.
I don't know what. Nothing to me. What does chastise mean?
Mea culpa to me. Got me?
I got you. Don't worry about it, man.
My bad, Mac.
No worries.
Shannon missed the free throw, which he does not do very often, but Quinnipiac the rebound. Now Omar Shannon down the left side, goes up, gets clobbered, ball loose, picked up by Drame, gets it to Azatam, and it goes up, hits the top of the backboard, and will go out of play. Boy, they're letting him play inside, I'll tell you that.
Boy, I tell you what, Billy, you were right. Omar Shannon never misses free throws, so that one-on-one is critical. The two Shaq misses, that's 4 points Quinnipiac gives back. And now it's a six-point game, would have been a 10-point game, and maybe the cushion you needed. So they got to continue to guard, unfortunately.
Robinson brings it across midcourt, and a whistle away from the ball. Conti, who is trying to guard Deion Jones, that is not a good matchup for Quinnipiac. Holden Jones commits the foul. That's team foul number six on Quinnipiac. So they're not over the limit yet, but Monmouth will inbound from the baseline.
That was Brian O'Connell's message to Tommy Moore saying, listen, I heard it down there. I'm going to call a foul just so you can be quiet on the bench.
It probably was. Robinson along the left sideline. Top of the key, it goes to Nicholas. Nicholas fumbles the ball, picks it up, gives to Jones down the right side. Whistle, foul. Conti called for the foul. He's got to get Conti off Jones. I mean, that's just not going to happen.
Well, it's a difficult matchup for Evan, especially when he hasn't had consistent minutes where he can get his sea legs right, Billy, in a sense of how fast he needs to play defensively. But I'm amazed now offensively the way the game has changed and the rules have changed. Where offensive players on the perimeter are taking a running start like a fullback, dribbling the ball and going directly to the basket. There's no possible way to stop them unless you take a charge, and you know how hard that is to do.
It is. These days, those are not being called with any frequency. Free throw by Jones is good. He now has 16 points and has one more coming.
You got to make your free throws. 9 for 12 for Monmouth, and Quinnipiac now 6 for 13. And two of those front ends of the one-on-one. So free throw shooting haunting the Bobcats.
Second, no good. Battle for the rebound. Comes to the floor, picked up by O'Gara, and he's fouled by Hurst. Hurst reached in to try and grab it away from him, commits the foul. And with the Bobcats over the limit, Monmouth will shoot 1-1.
I don't know what Coach Moore's yelling at, but he's yelling two times. I'm not sure what that means, but the bottom line is maybe two times they haven't been able to clear a rebound on a missed free throw. That's what he should be focusing on, and that's what Drama and Azatam need to come up with the basketball.
Free throw by O'Gara, no good. And three times, Monmouth gets the rebound. Back out to O'Gara, into the lane. Shot by Brady is blocked, knocked out of bounds by Monmouth.
Boy, you got to rebound a basketball, Quinnipiac. You're taking some possessions off, and it's going to come back and haunt them.
6 minutes, 40 seconds remaining. Bobcats have a five-point lead, 53-48.
That was a great block by Drame.
His fifth of the night. Umar Shannon across midcourt, met by a zone defense. Throws right side for Conti, back to Shannon. Shannon dribbles to the left side, gives to Hurst along the left sideline. Back out to Shannon. Under 20 on the shot clock to Drame at the foul line. Drame into the lane, spins, and has his arm grabbed, and a foul is called. DeLeo commits the foul. That's going to be 10th team foul for Monmouth. It's going to put Drame at the line to shoot two.
Good move by Drame, and he needs to be careful because when he puts the ball on the floor, they got a lot of guys darting at him. And you got to be aware. You got that peripheral vision. See who's coming at you. Be able to pick it up quick and then deliver the pass. He hasn't passed it well out of double team. Back rim.
Oh, he got them all. He touched them all. Shaq Shannon back in, replacing Evan Conti. Jones and DeLeo go to the bench as James and Nicholas back in for Monmouth.
Quinnipiac slowed the game down, and that happens when you get to the foul line, and really has taken Monmouth's best offense away, which has been that transition offense.
Second by Drame, rolls off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Brady. Monmouth on the run. Bobcats up by six, 54-48, 6:10 remaining. Brady top of the key, gives right side for Nicholas, comes off a pick to the right, to the left side, throws it in the lane, down low, shot blocked by Azatam, but a foul is called. Chris Brady went up, Azatam blocked the ball, but obviously he got a piece of Brady, and Brady will go to the line to shoot two.
Well, the move, O'Brien O'Connell, and I love him, as official said, he got him with the body. He didn't get him with the body that time. So the only way he made that foul that time is if he hit his wrist. There was no contact at all with the lower body.
Brady's free throw is good. Chris Brady, 6'10", freshman of Greenlawn, New York, now with 4 points in the ball game and one more free throw coming.
Yeah, not a bad flip from the foul line for the big fella.
Second off the back rim, no good. Rebound, Drame. Gets it out to Shaq Shannon. Shannon into the front court. Shannon throws left side. Hurst puts up a three. Good.
Good job by Shannon. He didn't take the shot. Hurst waited to see Azatam and Drame for an offensive rebound and let it fly. He's played really well in the second half, Willie.
Bobcats by 8, 57-49. Robinson top of the key, comes down the right side, up with the floater, banks it and puts it in.
Little man does a pretty good job when he gets inside there. You know, he goes 5'6", but pretty strong down there.
Yeah, listed at 5'8", you're probably right, though. He probably is closer to 5'6". Little guy, a lot of speed and good jump. Hurst again for three. This one off the rim, no good, but rebounded by Drame. Drame to the lane, to the basket, goes up, and he's fouled. Drame has been a beast off the boards tonight, and he'll go to the line to try and make two free throws.
Well, he was pretty to watch that time. I mean, honestly, he looked like Brian Botano when he goes ahead and does the triple axle, and he gets up there and he just floats through the air, and you're wondering, Brian, are you ever going to come down? And Usman Drame finally came down and got fouled.
Sure, that was a triple axle or a triple Lutz?
I think it was the Lutz. Yeah, I think it was the Lutz. Because the axle, you just spin and spin and spin and spin. I get dizzy when I watch that. So you were right, it was the Lutz.
Doesn't take a lot, Billy.
I'm dizzy when I wake up.
And again, the officials over-checking the video, and I'm not quite sure why, but...
I don't know, are they allowed to look at the video to see if it's a two-shot foul or is it a one-on-one? Because that would be the only thing.
Well, they're over the 10-foul limit, so it's two
really
shots
matter.
Anyway.
Right. It doesn't really matter. Maybe they're trying to figure out who committed the foul.
That might have been first by Drame.
Step up big now, Quinnipiac, 8 for 16 from the foul line. And you listen to coaches at the end of the game saying, we can't blame missed free throws for losing the game.
Well, guess what? You can.
Yes, you
can.
Yeah, you can. Because that's why you lose basketball games when you don't make free throws.
Drame hits two. He's got 13 points to go along with a bushel of rebounds. 59-51, Bobcats by 8, 5 minutes and 12 seconds remaining. Robinson into the front court, looks over at King Rice. The coach gives him a play, comes to the right side, throws top of the key to James. Josh James moves left, guarded by Shaq Shannon. Now back to Robinson, top of the key, throws right side for Jones. Deion Jones lobs it to James, cutting for the hoop, up and banks it in over Drame.
They move well without the ball. Regardless of it's Jones or Nicholas, that time James, curl cut for a basket.
Under 5 minutes to play, Bobcats with a six-point lead. Right side, Umar Shannon. Now top of the key for Shaq Shannon. Shaq Shannon bounces once, gives left side for Hurst. Hurst on the move to the top of the key for Shannon. Down low for Drame to the basket. Reverse, blocked, taken away by Monmouth. James down the lane, driving shot is good.
That transition, they're really good. They're able to take it 94 feet. They don't look to pass out of transition. They look to finish and... Missed opportunity that time by Drame and a good feed by Shannon.
4-point lead for the Bobcats with just over 4 minutes to play. Umar Shannon, right side, comes to the top key, bounces left side for Shaq Shannon. Shaq Shannon puts it on the floor. Under 4 minutes left now, 15 on the shot clock. Umar Shannon along the right sideline. They get it to James Ford into the lane. The jump off the rim, no good. Rebound, Hurst, and he lays it in.
Real good job by James Ford. I don't mind the missed shot because that happens, but it gave Hurst an opportunity to clean it up inside. You got to get a stop here, Quinnipiac.
6-point Bobcat lead and a whistle away from the ball, and they're going to call the foul on James Ford. Jones was cutting through the lane, and they call Ford for holding him.
Boy, he elbowed him right in the jaw. They really missed that one. Wow.
3:37 left. Timeout on the floor. Quinnipiac 61, Monmouth 55 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Have you had your coffee today? Oh, you're on your third cup already? This is Dan Darling of CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com. And along with that third cup, how about a coffee break for the soul? Go to CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com and create your username and password. and I'll provide daily inspiration for your soul. Why? Because your soul is worth it. CoffeeBreakForTheSoul.com. Sign up today.
Discover Spain with Worcester Street Travel on this wonderful 15-day tour of beautiful Spain. Visit Spain, Portugal, and southern France, including Barcelona, Seville, Madrid, Lisbon, and the Pyrenees Mountains. Escorted by Yolanda of Worcester Street Travel, September 3rd to the 18th, 2014, your travel itinerary in Spain includes Barcelona, Lourdes, Salamanca, Lisbon, Seville, and Madrid. Call Yolanda at Worcester Street Travel to reserve your seat, 203-281-5888.
We are back.
The Bobcats have a six-point lead over Monmouth as we come down the stretch, and there is no sweat down in Jersey City today for the Lady Bobcats. Under 3 minutes to play, they lead St. Peter's 67-37.
I like that score, you know, and I think I'm a little excited. Kick it back a little bit. You got Yolanda's number.
Man, I tell you what, man, we take you out of Jersey City and you wake up.
I'm fine. I feel safe. I grew up in Bowie.
I got you. Deion Jones at the line to shoot two for Monmouth. His first is up and off the front rim, no good. Jones, leading scorer for the Hawks with 16 points. Actually, leading scorer in the ball game with 16.
He's been pretty good. And, you know, I think the one thing missing from his arsenal, and it, as he leaves from Towson, which is a Colonial League, he doesn't really shoot the three, but he does everything else really well.
Missed two free throws there, though, and it's rebounded by Drame. Drame now with 19 rebounds on the night.
He's been incredible for Quinnipiac.
Bobcats out of the backcourt. They give it to Umar Shannon, right side. Shannon has a pick, doesn't use it, still dribbles out near the top of the key. 3:20 left in the game, under 20 on the shot clock. Shannon, right side, now comes back to the top of the key, gives left side for Shaq Shannon, down low for Azatam, knocked away, recovered by Umar Shannon, fakes, shot, blocked by Jones, with the shot clock winding down ahead for James. James out of the backcourt to the basket, lays it up and hits over Azatam.
Well, he's really athletic, and in transition, he's been a handful for Quinnipiac.
He's been impressive. It's a four-point Bobcat lead with under 3 minutes to play. Zaid Hurst, left side, lobs it to Azatam at the foul line, fires it down low to Drame, tried to dunk it and missed. He got hit in the face. Drame down on the floor. Hurst got the rebound, and now a whistle for the injury timeout. Drame, I don't know if he got poked in the eye, poked in the nose, but he's holding his face down in the lane.
Looks like he's going to get up a little bit, Billy, and I don't think he hit his face on the rim. He certainly was high enough, but it looks like he got poked in the eye by the defender.
Oh, yeah. Now that they've stopped play, does he have to come out of the game?
Oh, my goodness, I would think he does, but there's no doubt on that replay as we got a chance to see it. It could be a flagrant where an official didn't call a foul. Now that would go in the record books. We got a chance to see it here.
And they're going to go look at it again. They're over at the video.
Did you take a peek up there on the scoreboard?
No, I missed that.
Yeah, I tell you what, Billy, he got the ball along the baseline, and you saw in a real good feed, he took off two-hand tomahawk, and then you saw the defender from Monmouth really lay into him. No foul was called, but they're going to look, and they're going to see if it's a flagrant or it was nothing.
Well, let's see what they're going to do. Quinnipiac did have the basketball, and I think they're just going to give the basketball back to Quinnipiac. That is what they are doing.
Well, I guess as long as they can't change it and make it a foul, but they can make it a flagrant, and they chose not to.
Bobcats to inbound. They get it in. Shaq Shannon gets double-teamed, dribbles away from it. Gets the ball to Umar Shannon, 2.5 remaining. Down to the left baseline for Drame, dribbles it out, now gets to Shaq Shannon up high. Shannon up at the top of the key against the zone, gives it left side. Umar Shannon thought about a three. 15 on the shot clock, 2:20 left in the game. Hurst thought about a three. Now Umar Shannon open for three. Good.
Way to share the basketball in a real good possession. three Bobcats pass up the open shot, and Shannon to Hurst to knock down the tray.
14 now for Umar Shannon, and King Rice, the coach of the Monmouth Hawks, calls a timeout. 2:08 remaining, and the Bobcats open up a 7-point lead, 64-57.
Individual commitment to a group effort. That's what makes a team work. And on that possession for Quinnipiac, three Bobcats passed up an apparent shot, and they got it to the right guy at the right time, and he knocks down a huge three.
Quinnipiac trying to go to 5-2 in the MAC conference with a game against some school called Niagara coming up here on Saturday. You've ever heard of that place?
N-I-A-G-A-R-A. That'll be interesting.
That's the Purple Eagles.
That's the Purple Eagles, led by Anthony Mason's son, who
leads
the country in scoring.
Yeah.
You know, a young guy that didn't go with Joe Mihalik, who was the coach of Niagara, left to take Oscar, took two of his best players with him. Mason stays, and Mason's had freedom to do whatever he wants. I'm sure his pop will be here on Saturday, right?
Well, maybe we'll try and get him on at halftime. Oh, Anthony Mason loved him when he was with the Knicks.
Boy, he competed.
He competed, is right. Monmouth with the basketball. They're down by 7 here with 2:04 remaining.
Can't give up a three here, Billy.
Robinson hands it off. James. James throws right side for Nicholas. Nicholas lob pass on the right left side for Jones. Into the lane. Driving shot. Off the back rim. No good. Rebound Hurst. Protects the ball. Hands off to Shaq Shannon with 1:45 remaining. Umar Shannon into the front court, runs away from a double team, gets the ball to Shaq Shannon underneath. Drama, and he dunks it home.
He'll make sure he finished that play. And again, really good job by Shannon. Shannon and Drama, the law firm on Whitney Avenue.
1:28 remaining. Bobcats by 9. Robinson and a foul away from the basketball. Azatam and Tillman jockeying for position, and Ike Azatam picks up the foul.
You wonder why Ike would be battling a guy in the low post who doesn't have the basketball. The last thing you
want. And doesn't have an offensive game.
Yeah, I mean, you just don't want to stop the clock. Let him catch the ball. Let him score. You'll win this game if you don't give up threes. If you exchange two for twos, Quinnipiac picks up their fifth win in the MAC conference.
First free throw by Tillman is good. He's got 10 points.
A young Brad Doherty.
He does look that way, yep. Doesn't quite have the skills of Mr. Doherty.
No, he doesn't, Coach.
Second free throw is good, though. Zach Tillman hits two foul shots. Monmouth calls a timeout with 1:23 remaining, and the Bobcats leading by 7, 66-59.
Well, you know you're going to get pressure, and I think what Monmouth does, and King Rice has done a good job, and their staff has done a good job, is they're not going to foul you right away. I think they have some confidence that they can turn you over in their full-court press offense. So it's critical now for Quinnipiac to look to attack the pressure. Catch, look forward, get somebody strong side middle behind the ball, and now look to punish Monmouth with two easy points. Don't play keep away. Really don't want to go to the foul line here, Billy. You want to play fast. You got a 6-point lead, 7-point lead. You want to play fast, you want to play loose, and you want to make them pay for scrambling on a defensive end.
So the two teams talk it over. Bobcats looking to salt this one away.
Yeah, that run in the end of that first half, you mentioned it a handful of times as we went into break, and then once again at halftime was really what the doctor ordered, because it righted the ship, and Quinnipiac then became committed to what they needed to be successful. Zaid Hurst started making some plays. Drame's been special, and that formula has been very good for Quinnipiac.
Usman Drame, one rebound away from 20, and he's the last Bobcat to have a 20-rebound game. In January of 2013.
He deserves it. And you're going to get a quick foul here by against Monmouth, holding, and we're going to get to the foul line. Umar Shannon will get a chance.
It's Shaq.
I hope it's Umar. They don't know. Last name's the same. Maybe you can switch the shooter.
Yeah, it will be Umar. Umar Shannon will go to the line. And he's missed his only foul shot so far tonight, but he is a 93% free throw shooter.
Yeah, if you had to pick one guy on Quinnipiac's team that you wanted on the foul line, there's no doubt, I think unanimously, even the crowd would pick Umar Shannon as he makes the free throw.
Makes one, has one more coming. Bobcats by eight.
He's had a real good second half, too, Billy. He's been really clean. You know, made some threes for Quinnipiac. He's done a good job with the ball.
Second. Rebound comes to the floor, picked up by Jones. Two guys go down, Shannon and Nicholas. Jones races into the front court, gives to James, into the lane, up with the shot. Good, and a foul.
You cannot make those foolish mistakes as a defender. Just let him score 2 points. What are you doing even being around him when he's inside?
Makes it a six-point game, and Josh James goes to the line to try to make this a three-point play. Billy, he very quietly has put up 11 points.
Well, I think what happened, Billy, you know, when Quinnipiac spent time guarding Nicholas and guarding Jones on the perimeter, no one was playing James. And then James turned around and decided it was time for him to make some plays, and he's done well.
Missed the foul shot. Shaq Shannon the rebound, and he is fouled. Deion Jones commits the foul, and now Shaq Shannon will go to the other end to shoot two.
You know, that's what you want to see for Quinnipiac down the stretch. In order to win a championship in the MAC, when you get fouled in a six-point game with a minute to go, you're going to step to that line with confidence and bury free throw after free throw. You can't be messy mess. You can't be You got to be committed to putting the ball in the basket.
Shaq Shannon.
There you go, Shaq.
Got fouled on a flagrant earlier in this half and missed both of those. Now he has a chance to make two here in the closing minute, and does. Second foul shot is good. 69-61, Bobcats by eight with a minute five remaining. James out of the backcourt, quickly down the right side, shot no good. And rebounded by Shaq Shannon, tried to jump in the air and pass the ball, instead hits the back of the backboard and turns it over.
When you're saving the ball underneath your basket, you're going to throw the ball as far as you possibly can down to the other end of the court. That way your team has a chance to, in a track meet, to beat the opponent. You never save the ball underneath your own basket, directly to your basket. You throw it 50 feet in the air and your team makes a play.
Christian White checks in. Inbounded. White apparently a three-point shooter. He's got Drame on him. Goes by Drame. Lays it up off the rim. No good. Rebound. Drame, and he's fouled. So there's rebound number 20 for Usman Drame, and he'll go to the other end, and he'll shoot two foul shots.
And the rebound was more important than the block.
Uh-huh.
So he figured, look, White's in the game. He's not making the shot. Let me get the rebound, and now I get my 20. Ball IQ.
Oh, Mac, you love it, man. You make it up as you go along.
There we go.
Drame has 15 points on the night. And 20 rebounds. First free throw, and no good. Bobcats by eight with 51 seconds remaining.
Boy, I like to see the guys take some time on the line. Keep your eye on the target. Put that ball in the basket, fellas.
Second, in and out. Missed them both. Rebound, Monmouth. James quickly into the front court. James to the right side. Looking, gets it into the right corner for Nicholas. Nicholas guarded tightly by Hurst. They both fall down. He gets the pass away to Jones. Whistle, offensive foul. Jones throws an elbow, and you probably got him that foul, Billy Mecca.
Well, we mentioned something to Brian about one he didn't miss, but one of his partners missed, and real good call by Brian O'Connell, who's one of the best in the business.
Bobcats with the ball, 36 seconds remaining. They're up by nine. Inbounded, Umar Shannon. Shannon hits a double team, and he gets fouled. Christian White reaches in, commits the foul, and Umar Shannon will walk to the other end and shoot two for the Bobcats with 33 seconds left.
This game would have been over a long time ago, Billy, if Quinnipiac had made the free throws. I mean, Quinnipiac's going to win this game, but 12 for 23 from the line is just... And it has a team, they haven't done that all year. They've been shooting 73% from the foul line. So it's an aberration, but it can't happen in a basketball game.
Misses the free throw. He's missed three free throws tonight, and he's a 93% foul shooter. Has one more coming.
Stay on the line. You know, he's moving a little bit, and he's leaning into the shot. Just stay there.
He stays there, and he makes it. 16 for Umar Shannon. Bobcats by 9. James quickly into the front court. Hands it off. White heaves a 3 off the rim. No good. Rebound, Drame. Rebound number 21. He hands to Hurst, and Hurst.
Quinnipiac defensively in the second half. You know, and I talked about two stops and two scores, and that's what Quinnipiac did in that two-point game, got it up to 6. Now, unfortunately, they haven't got it past 6, 7, or 8 because they haven't made their free throws, but a really good dominant performance by the Bobcats down the stretch to outscore Monmouth by 10 in the final 3 minutes and to be up 9. Yeah, outscoring them by 19 in the final 24 minutes.
First by Hurst, off the back rim, no good. Heavens to Betsy, Mr. Mecca.
Boy, that's frustrating, man. And I'm not even coaching this team. I mean, man.
Hurst with one more coming. He missed them both. Rebounded by Monmouth. James quickly up court. Dishes right side. Long 3 by DeLeo. Off the rim, no good. Rebound is knocked out of bounds by Monmouth. Drame with 21 rebounds, Billy. That's a career high for him. But, again, the foul shooting has been atrocious tonight.
Yeah, it's just frustrating. I mean, any way you look at it, you know, it takes away what's going to be a real good win for Quinnipiac.
Inbounded to Drame. Double team. Gets it away to Shaq Shannon. Less than 10 seconds to play. Now to James Ford, throws into the front court to Shannon. Monmouth calls off the dogs, and this one comes to an end. Final score, Quinnipiac 61. Stay tuned. The Morrow Motors postgame show comes your way right after this. Zaid Hurst throws up ahead for Shannon, comes along the left sideline, gets it down low. Azatam drives to the basket, no good. Rebound, Drame! Reverse layup is good. Dribble, gives it off Drame at the foul line. The jump. Nazatam, his first touch of the night. Down the lane, driving shot. Good as he banks it in.
Well, great job by Azatam.
Jones, five on the shot clock. Pull up jump. Lay off the mark. Jones gets his rebound. Blocked by basket. Looks to make a move. Now puts up the jump. Good.
Yeah, better patience.
Kicks it out for Shannon. Shannon into the front court. Pulls up. Three-pointer. Good.
Yeah, he got in rhythm that time.
One pass out top to Key Chandler. Left side, Umar Shannon. Shannon, pull up jump. Good.
I like to see it to him a little bit.
Left side, O'Gara. Down low in the lane. Rudiker shot blocked. Rebounded by Drame and lays it in. It's a free throw, but Drame cleans it up. Bobcats, though, down. Umar Shannon, left corner for Hurst. Hurst into the lane. Pull up jump. Good.
You got to attack on a real good
front
move.
Front court for Hurst. Hurst on the move. Down the right side. Pull up jump at the baseline. No good. Tip by Drame is good.
A good job.
Stutter steps. Kicks it out. Umar Shannon down the lane. Scoop shot is good.
I think he yelled Omaha.
Court just to Hurst. Into the right corner. Shaq Shannon for three. Off the rim. No good. Rebound. Hurst goes up. No good. Rebound. Forward. And he lays
down
it in.
Top of the key for Robinson. To the foul line. To the basket. Shot blocked from behind. Rebound. Shannon in the lane. Back out. Ford for three. Good. And we're tied at 29.
James Ford has given the team a little bit of life, hasn't he, Willie?
He has indeed. 11 straight. Second half. Azatam at the foul line. Bounces once out to Hurst for three. Good.
Care whether he makes them or not.
Umar to the top of the key, gets to Shaq Shannon, down underneath. Drame, turnaround jump is good.
And into the front court. Shannon avoids a pick, pulls up the jump. Good.
Real good job by Umar.
Drives to the lane, pulls up, gets it out. Umar Shannon, baseline jump. Good.
You got to get him the ball, right? That's what they're doing.
Marcelo Rudiger, inbound to Drame, lays it up and hits.
Real
good. Inside of 40, Drame gets it out to Hurst, goes to the right baseline, fadeaway jump. Good.
Good job by Drame, Billy.
Gets it out, Shaq Shannon. Shannon to Hurst for three. Good.
Always throw the ball back to
Travel, hands it off to James. Has it blocked and taken away by Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt to Azatam, who dunks. The rebound back out to O'Garo into the lane. Shot by court. Shannon throws left side. Hurst puts up a three. Good.
Good job by Shannon. He didn't take
it. Get it to James Ford into the lane. The jump off the rim. No good. Rebound. Hurst, and he lays it in.
Real good job by James.
20 left in the game. Hurst thought about a three. Now Umar Shannon open for three. Good.
Way to share the basketball.
And into the front court. Runs away from a double team. Gets the ball to Shaq Shannon underneath. Drama, and he dunks it home.
He'll make sure.
Clock. Shaq Shannon puts up a three. Good.
Not good possession that time.
Side with the dribble, gives it off Drame at the foul line. The jump. Azatam, his first touch of the night. Down the lane, driving shot. Good as he banks it in.
Well, great job by Azatam.
Jones, five on the shot clock. Pull up jump. Way off the mark. Jones gets his rebound. Blocked by basket. Looks to make a move. Now puts up the jump. Good.
Yeah, better patience. With
kicks it out for Shannon. Shannon into the front court. Pulls up. Three-pointer. Good.
Yeah, he got in rhythm that time.
One pass out top to Key Chandler. Left side, Umar Shannon. Shannon, pull up, jump. Good.
I like to see it to him a
His
little
left
bit.
Left side, O'Gara. Down low in the lane. Rudiker shot blocked. Rebounded by Drame and lays it in. It's a free throw, but Drame cleans it up. Bobcats, though, down. Umar Shannon, left corner for Hurst. Hurst into the lane. Pull up, jump. Good.
You got to attack on a real good
front
move.
Front court for Hurst. Hurst on the move, down the right side. Pull up, jump at the baseline. No good. Tip by Drame is good.
A good job.
Stutter steps, kicks it out. Umar Shannon down the lane. Scoop shot is good.
I think he yelled Omaha.
Court just to Hurst. Into the right corner. Shaq Shannon for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound. Hurst goes up, no good. Rebound forward, and he lays
down
it in.
Top of the key for Robinson. To the foul line, to the basket. Shot blocked from behind. Rebound, Shannon in the lane. Back out, Ford for three. Good,
and we're tied at 29.
James Ford has given the team a little bit of life, hasn't he, Willie?
He has indeed. 11 straight. second half. Azatam at the foul line. Bounces once out to Hurst for three. Good.
Care whether he makes them or not.
Umar to the top of the key. Gets to Shaq Shannon. Down underneath. Drama. Turnaround jump is good.
And
into the front court. Shannon avoids a pick. Pulls up the jump. Good.
Real good job by Umar.
Drives to the lane. Pulls up. Gets it out. Umar Shannon. Baseline jump. Good.
You got to get him the ball, right? That's what they do.
Marcelo Rudiger. Inbound to Drame. Lays it up and hits.
Real good. I like that score, you know. And I think I'm a little excited.
Game tied at 40. Drame gets it out to Hurst. Goes to the right baseline. Fadeaway jump. Good.
Good job by Drame, Billy.
Gets it out. Shaq Shannon. Shannon to Hurst for three. Good.
Always throw the ball back to
Travel,
the guy.
Hands it off to James. Has it blocked and taken away by Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt to Azatam, who dunks. The rebound back out to Ogero into the lane. Shot by court. Shannon throws left side. Hurst puts up a three. Good.
Good job by Shannon. He didn't take
it. Get it to James Ford into the lane. The jump off the rim. No good. Rebound. Hurst, and he lays it in.
Real good job by James.
20 left in the game. Hurst thought about a three. Now Umar Shannon open for three. Good.
Way to share the basketball.
And into the front court. Runs away from a double team. Gets the ball to Shaq Shannon underneath. Drama, and he dunks it home.
He'll make sure.